Marvel stuff. These two Marvel Universe films will fix a big Marvel problem. See what the Cosmic Wonder has to say about this and check this out.
What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to the Cosmic Wonder. I'm Warner Thompson, and a lot has been happening in the Marvel Cinematic Universe lately, not just in the universe itself, but with Marvel Studios as well. Yesterday, we talked about the changes that Marvel Studios could be implementing with the MCU relatively soon, a strategy of cutting back severely on Disney Plus shows. Now, in the video yesterday, I asked you all what you thought about it, and I saw a lot of comments talking about how, yes, there have been a lot of shows coming from Marvel Studios lately. The frequency is high for the Disney Plus shows, but first and foremost, the quality just has been a little bit lacking. That is just one of the issues that Marvel Studios right now is trying to fix, and it looks like they're going to be doing this in another big way as well. Something that we haven't entirely gotten yet is a ton of connectivity in the MCU. With so many different projects and movies going on, sometimes it's really hard to tell how everything is connecting, but apparently that is going to be changing really soon in two specific projects. Now, of course, they'll show us the connectivity in other projects as well, but we're hearing that one specific project is going to fill in the gaps of a lot of other shows and movies that we've seen that we've been waiting for. We've been waiting for these gaps to be filled. We've been waiting to feel a more connectivity to the MCU. And everything has been set up, even in these individual Disney Plus shows. The ones that feel like they haven't connected, they will indeed start to feel like that soon. And with the other movie, it's not necessarily going to fill in the gaps like this other movie is, but bring everything together, making everything feel really connected and pushing that connectivity forward in the MCU. So we'll break down everything you need to know in this video, including talking about the one project that Marvel Studios is going to use to connect a lot of the MCU together. So if you're new, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of the latest MCU news. And if you subscribe and leave a comment, you're automatically entered in our giveaway for a chance to win an Xbox Series X, a PS5, some Marvel Legends items, or some DC items as well. The winner gets to pick one item, and we pick a winner at the end of each month. Among the complaints of Marvel fans recently has been that they feel a lack of connectivity. But in the start of the Marvel Cinematic Universe in Phase 1 and Phase 2, there wasn't a ton of connectivity yet. Yes, everything did connect and there were Easter eggs and tie-ins to other projects, but until really Phase 3 started, there wasn't a ton of connectivity. Just think back on the first two phases. We had Iron Man, The Incredible Hulk, Iron Man 2, Thor, Captain America, and the Avengers film. All of those really stood on their own. Of course, they connected and had Easter eggs and tie-ins to other movies, but for the most part, they were their own films. But then in Phase 2, we got Iron Man 3. That was really on its own, except for Tony talking about the Battle of New York and how he had PTSD from it. Thor the Dark World really stood on its own. Then we had Captain America the Winter Soldier. That movie felt connected because Nick Fury was in it, Black Widow was in it, Bucky was in it as the Winter Soldier, of course. But Guardians of the Galaxy stood on its own, and that is really kind of when we met Thanos for the first time, and that's kind of where it starts. Ant-Man kind of stood on its own. We did have the scene where he goes to the Avengers facility and fights Falcon, but again, for the most part, that film was on its own. It was only until Phase 3 where everything felt super connected because we had Captain America Civil War that brought all the previous heroes together. Doctor Strange and Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2 really stood on their own as well, but they were brought in a really big way in Avengers Infinity War. Then Spider-Man Homecoming, of course, felt super connected because it had Tony Stark. Thor Ragnarok had the Hulk, and it picked up right after Civil War. Black Panther was a movie on its own, but of course it connected to Infinity War in a really big way as well. And then with Ant-Man and the Wasp, the ending directly tied into Infinity War and would end up going right into Avengers Endgame, minus Captain Marvel, which doesn't take place at the same time in the MCU, of course. But Captain Marvel was brought in into Endgame, and then after Endgame, we had Spider-Man Far From Home, which of course still really showed the presence of Tony Stark. But again, all these really big projects that felt super connected didn't really happen until Phase 3, and that's kind of where we're heading right now. We haven't seen too much connectivity, but the first two phases didn't show a lot of it as well. Originally, what brought the heroes and projects together were the Avengers films, and we're about to kind of get our first mini Avengers film with Captain America Brave New World. This is one of the films that I was talking about. This is supposed to be kind of just like Captain America Civil War. Now, when I say that, I don't mean the Avengers are going to be fighting each other, but I mean it's basically going to be a big ensemble of superheroes coming together on screen. An unofficial Avengers film, because that's what everybody kind of considers Captain America Civil War. An Avengers film without the title. And again, like I mentioned, Civil War was a huge project for the MCU as a whole, because moving forward from there, a lot of things really started to connect more, and it looks like that's the same thing that is going to be happening right after Captain America Brave New World. Our heroes are going to come together, and they're going to stay together for the future, going into the Kang Dynasty, going into Avenger Secret Wars, and this will be where things start to really connect going forward, because the heroes are now going to be in constant contact with each other and learning about what is happening in the multiverse. So this film will be a game changer for the current state of the MCU right now. If you felt like it was lacking a little bit, it's going to completely change after this film. The tone and the pacing of the MCU is going to be completely different. But again, I also spoke of a different project. A project that is going to start to fill in some gaps for other films and shows. And that project is the project that is going to immediately follow up Captain America Brave New World, and that is the Thunderbolts. The Thunderbolts and Captain America Brave New World are going to be two huge pivotal points for the MCU. We recently heard from the director of the Thunderbolts and from insiders as well, giving us some info about the movie and how it will fill in gaps. We'll talk about that in just a bit, but first, big thank you to Bird Dogs for sponsoring this video. If you struggle with finding good shorts to wear, ones that actually fit and actually look good, the struggle is over. Bird Dogs make you look good, and they are extremely comfortable. Bird Dogs are specifically designed to look slimmer on the thigh and the leg, giving you a sculpted look. And the best part is they are stretch khaki shorts. They do the exact same thing as Lululemon, but they fit way better. Most shorts out there don't fit very well. They're pretty restricting. They're stiff. The cotton they use is pretty terrible, but Bird Dogs fixes this issue by inventing cloud knit fabric that looks just like khaki, but stretches so you get a way slimmer fit without having to sacrifice movement. They also use anti-stink sweat wickening fabric that helps keep you cool and dry all day long. I personally really struggled with shorts because I'm not a tall guy and I'm kind of bulky, and I have not been able to find shorts that aren't too long that actually allow me to move, but now I have with Bird Dogs. They are awesome, and the best part is if you order a pair, you get a free Yeti style tumbler. So go to birddogs.com/cosmic for a free Yeti style tumbler with your order. That's birddogs.com/cosmic for a free Yeti style tumbler. You won't want to take your Bird Dogs off, we promise you. So in Captain America Brave New World, and the Thunderbolts are where things are going to start to turn around, and where you're going to really start to feel the connectivity of all of the different projects that have been happening. And today we've heard from insider Can We Get Some Toast, and we've even heard from the director of the upcoming Thunderbolts movie, Jake Schreier. He says that the Thunderbolts project will not serve as a sequel to any previous Marvel project. Yes, these characters have appeared before, but it is a new story being told, and a story with a very different perspective than people are expecting, is what he recently told Collider. In which the insider Can We Get Some Toast responded to that tweet stating, "Not a sequel, no, but Thunderbolts does follow up on Ant-Man and the Wasp, Black Widow, Falcon and the Winter Soldier, and Hawkeye. It'll fill in the gaps of where everyone's been since those projects and what they've been up to. And of course, if we take a look at the characters that are a part of the Thunderbolts, that just makes sense. We're going to figure out what these people and who they're associated with have been up to over the years. And that'll bring a different connectivity to the MCU, but still making it feel more connected. But that's not all it's going to do. This is actually going to set up events that are going to take place beyond Phase 6 of the MCU. We've learned that the Thunderbolts are going to go to Tiamat Island to try and get adamantium for the US government. We've also heard a rumor that the Weapon X program could be introduced in the MCU in the Thunderbolts project. And if they are going for adamantium, this makes sense. Now, of course, the MCU could switch things up a little bit, and it could be Thunderbolt Ross who is in charge of the Weapon X program, along with Valentina. Again, story-wise in the MCU, this makes sense. Ross has been experimenting with Super Soldier Serum for the longest time now. Valentina is the one who put the Thunderbolts together. It would make sense that they would want a different enhanced team, one that they have created, literally. So regardless of the fact that the Thunderbolts is going to fill in some MCU gaps, it is also going to be a big setup for the future as well. And I think everything for the MCU is really going to start to come together thanks to these two films that aren't that far away. So if you're one of the fans that have been waiting for that specific connected feeling of the Marvel Cinematic Universe, you don't have to wait that much longer, but go ahead and let us know what you think about this in the comments down below. Please don't forget to like the video and subscribe so you don't miss out on any of the latest videos. You can always follow us on Instagram and Twitter as well, and as always, thank you all so much for watching. Woof woof.
Please subscribe, like this video, have a great day, and thanks so much for watching, and see you guys, bye.